There's one thing to be told. These dreams are made to be called, and friends can never be barred. Doesn't matter how long it's been, I know you'll always jump in, cause we don't know how to quit. Let's start a riot tonight, a pack alliance tonight. In this world, he who stops won't get anything he wants. Play like the top 1% till nothing's left to be spent. Take it all off the tape, celebrate, because we are the champions.
Alright, so what happened last time was that Deku defeated All For One using his giant avatar. And let's say like the media did not see his face that much, if I said they did. So he doesn't get amateur recognition. But a lot of people in Class 1A and some people who saw like the sports festival recognize who it is. And the teacher's like had like the special move training, and everything he has is the same. And let's say Deku, his special move training is just like trying to release as much energy of the black beast while keeping control with it. So say it gets to the point where Deku can't release so much energy of the dark beast, of the black beast, to the point that he's almost unstoppable. Alright, so yeah, so he's almost unstoppable. Then we go to the, and the boulder still falls, but yeah, All Might still has like small man form. Let's say Bakugo, he's trained a lot more. So when he like blasts the rubble, he sees like the chunk falling in All Might. Bakugo still is able to like, his AP shot, let's say he got a lot faster. Like a lot faster, like in a split second he's able to just like shoot it out. Actually, he takes a less time charge and he becomes a lot larger, so he's able to like quickly like snipe it off, and like a couple of rocks like fall onto All Might, but most of all like people are like impressed about how much progress he got. I'll say to this that Kirishima also, like, because he's Bakugo's partner, Bakugo got a lot stronger, so Kirishima started training even more and more and more in his hardening quirk, which, it's not going to be a spoiler, but Red Ryan Unbreakable, you guys know. So he's able to turn into Red Ryan Unbreakable, but so he's just like a very short time, like not even 60 seconds, like 10 maximum, just like, and yeah, if let's move on, the provisional license exam happens, we get the same interactions. A lot of people like people don't know that much about Deku's strength, but some people do like think that what his power is, because they saw like his like manifestations, they heard about like the giant monster, like a giant humanoid that defeated All For One, but they don't, and they tie back to Deku and having a similar quirk like that. So the exam starts, the same speeches are given, everything is done the same. UA still runs, everybody still like tries to crush UA. And Deku just flicks his hand up and just like raises this giant dark force of energy. Just like solid, just like stops every attack from hitting them. And it's like And they get like stuck and then absorbed in it. And he hands them out to like everybody in class 1A and says, "Hey guys, you know what? Ready, set, fire." As everybody in class 1A just like starts like eliminating opponents left and right. And yeah. And like every battle like goes pretty good. A lot of people like in UA still like pass. Let's say Bakugo actually passes the exam. And because Bakugo is like, he refuses to like think that he knows that Deku. But let's say he starts to like think that if he trains with Deku a lot more, he can get a lot stronger than he is right now. So yeah, everything goes the same like that. All right, let's see. So then let's move on to the meeting of the big three. Everybody's like still flustered, and people are still like shocked at meeting the big three, and everything like that. And then the fight with Mirio happens the same. Mirio like knocks out everybody in class 1A, but Deku, he does something cruel. When Mirio like rises, like tries to hit him by rising up to the ground, Deku just uses Seaver to form even more surface. So Mirio miscalculates a lot of his moves, and at a time Mirio like, let's say because Mirio can't breathe at the time, like he does fight Deku easier, harder, like a lot. Deku a lot stronger, but Deku can't use most of his other moves because Mirio will just go right through him. So he decides to build a lot more distance between him and Mirio. So Mirio's like quirk is like, he found out the flaw that Mirio can't breathe because he sees Mirio getting tired after more distance is applied. So Deku just applied a lot more of it, and Mirio like lost a lot of oxygen to his brain, and he got knocked out. I say like a lot of people are surprised, like the deck just take down the Mirio, which is like super strong. I see even Sun Eater and like the girl of the big three, I forgot her name. They're like shocked, and let's say Sun Eater is just like, asked Deku, how did he do that? And Deku says, "Well, I realized that after adding even more distance between me and Mirio, he started to lose breath over time. His breathing became disrupted. So I decided to put even more distance between us to see how much, to the point that he can't recover his breath fast enough." And let's say Sun Eater is like still like shy, like Sun Eater is still like shy, but, and Deku asks him like, "Why are you shy so much? You deserve praise." He says that you deserve praise. You're part of the big three. Your analysis is actually very strong. The only thing holding you back is your personality. Now, if you change that a little bit, you'll be able to surpass everybody, even Mirio." And let's say Sun Eater like takes that advice, and like, he tries to become more and more confident. And yeah. And Kirishima like still has his hardening quirk, and just like, Let's go to like the work studies. Everything goes the same. So Kirishima has a lot of easier time just to go into his Red Ryan Unbreakable. Which, let's say we're like 1 minute and a half. So like he's able to like, well, like the Blade villain uses like that syringe and injects that quirk steroid into him. Like, he's able to break off, like, a lot of the blades. But he doesn't turn out of, like, his Red Ryan Unbreakable mode when he punches the sword villain into the chest. In the chest. And, yeah. The villain gets taken in, and... Oh, I forgot to mention... So this is like cutting back to like overhaul meeting Shigaraki. Shigaraki's like a lot more hesitant and he's a lot more angry at and that his whole entire team and his whole entire plan got destroyed, so overhaul is a lot more confident. And let's see. So overhaul's like a lot more confident about the way he's speaking and like criticizing Shigaraki. Shigaraki's quirk did get stronger because if he just here's just gotta say Shigaraki's quirk got a lot stronger in the manga, so he can probably like his decay got a lot faster and he can use it like in a giant wide radius. So an overhaul like rushes towards him, like when Overhaul's meeting doesn't go down that well, Overhaul tries to shoot Shigaraki with his bullet. Well, it gets disintegrated. Yeah. It gets disintegrated. And Kirigiri like still like absorbs like a lot of like over bullets and he allows Shigaraki to teleport his hand and touch the ground, like, decaying a lot. Like, a good chunk of it, which is, like, located to the ground. And, this caused, like, a bit of tension between Overhaul and, Shigaraki. But, Overhaul, like, backs down, because you see Shigaraki's, like, going full serious, and he does, and, Overhaul doesn't really want to. Overhaul says, well, you know what? I don't want to lose too many troops on this devil matter. This matter doesn't even concern me as much. Soon you'll join my path either way. And Shigaraki looks at Overhaul and scratches his neck and says, me join you? That must be, like, the weirdest thing you ever said. And both of them leave, and it's a lot of bad tension, to say the least. And, let's see. And, yeah, that covers a good amount on, like, the anime is there. Caught up to. So, yeah. And, oh, yeah, forgot. Nine-Eye's confrontation with Deku goes, like, Nine-Eye knows that Deku's strong. He was able to defeat Mirio. He sees him worthy enough. And Mirio didn't inherit one for all. There's also, like, a reason why he couldn't, like, fully control his quirk, because one for all makes a person's quirk more powerful, but which is for most people is yay, like a lot stronger powers. But for Mirio, because his quirk is so hard to control already, it's more of a barrier. Yeah, just wanted to add that in. And yeah, so the confrontation between Deku and Overhaul still happens. And Deku still, like, holds I forget the girl's name, Yuri, I think. Yui. Yeah. So that confrontation still happens. That, and they let Overhaul excite his conversation with Deku. Deku talks with Overhaul, saying that he's a hero and he doesn't want to leave anybody who's in danger. And Overhaul still tries to intimidate him by pulling his hand down. And let's see, Yui still runs to him, and both the Dark Beast and Deku have like a conversation in their head, just like, you notice that thing over there, that person was definitely a villain. Why didn't you go after him? And Deku says, well, there'll be a lot more lives lost than saved. We'll report it. And then maybe we'll take him down later. So yeah. Want to add on this, that if you guys want me to follow this thing into the manga, like, follow this what if, and any, like, pick 5 what ifs. And I'll continue them into the manga. If you guys want to, just comment yes or no, and then give like a what if that you guys want to be in the manga. So like, or I mean, also like add like spoiler alert, this may go into manga past this and this episode. It's not out yet. Yeah. See you guys. Have a wonderful day.